Fernanda Chavez. I'm a freshman from Benito Juarez Community Academy, Chicago, Illinois. I am reading The Glass Castle by Jeanette Walsh. This book was challenged on December 10, 2005 by a Phantom student at Traverse City West High School in Michigan. They said that the book contained too much explicit language, reference to child molestation, adult sexual exploit, and violence, as it recounts the author's experience growing up with an alcoholic father and a mother who suffered from mental illness. The Glass Castle should be available for people to read because it teaches kids that no matter what situation you're going through, you can still be successful in life. Now, I'm going to read a passage. The doctor said I was lucky to be alive. They took patches of skin from my upper thigh and put them over the most badly burned parts of my stomach, ribs, and chest. They said it was called a skin graft. When they were finished, they wrapped my entire right side in bandages. "Look, I'm a half mummy," I said to one of the nurses. She smiled and put my right arm in a sling and attached it to a headboard so I couldn't move it. The nurses and doctors kept asking me questions. "How did you get burned? Had your parents ever hurt you? Why do you have all these bruises and cuts?" "My parents never hurt me," I said. "I got the cuts and bruises playing outside and burns from cooking hot dogs." They asked what I was doing cooking hot dogs by myself at the age of 3. "It was easy," I said. "You just put the hot dogs in the water and boil them. It wasn't like there was some complicated recipe that you had to be old enough to follow. The pan was too heavy for me to lift when it was full of water. So I put a chair next to the sink, climb up and throw the glass, and then stand on a chair by the stove and pour the water into the pan. I did that over and over again until the pan held enough water. Then I turned on the stove, and when the water was boiling, I dropped in the hot dog. Mom says I'm mature for my age, I told her, and she lets me cook for myself a lot. The nurses looked at each other, and one of them wrote something down on a clipboard. I asked what was wrong.